bro. I think Leon gone, bro.
Leon, hey, he don't have that fight. He ain't got that fight, bro. He ain't got that fight him no more, bro. He ain't got that fight, bro. Mm-hmm. Yeah, look, girl, like what's name said, sometimes they don't come back from that, man. Like Jerome said, sometimes they don't come back. Sometimes because like when he was trying, I don't think Scully. I think Scully done, bro. I think Scully done folded, bro.
What? After he seen Condition in the meat locker,
bro. If he had the opportunity when his old lady was like, look, they got Leon, let's go. And he was already like, I don't know, man. We need to, you know what I'm saying? How you not go with your old lady, bro, when you know they got the man who killed your baby? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, he couldn't stop her, so he gotta go. You gotta go protect her, bro. Go with her, bro. Like, he ain't got that fight. He ain't had that fight in him, bro. Even when they was at the table in the last episode, bro, he just ain't been having that. You see how she smacked him upside the head with an ashtray?
What are you doing? That thing was going on. What are you doing? I was like,
smack my side of the head with the ashtray, bro. He ain't got it no more, bro. I don't think he got that fight in him no more, bro. They knocked the fight out of him, bro.
True, but I think Scully, like, bro, they just killed your brother. And all of a sudden they got Leon. I think he was like, you gotta get that hate out your heart, like, cause you ain't thinking. I'm like, emotional. They just killed your brother. Set him up. Killed him. Now all of a sudden they got Leon?
Are you finna run over there? Yeah, it made no sense, bro. Like, yeah. That's the difference between Franklin thinking and, you know what I'm saying, Khadijah and Scully and Manboy thinking. Like, you know what I'm saying? Franklin was like, look, man, we gotta slow down. We gotta think. We gotta play this smart because Jerome, they at the barbershop, they waiting on you, bro. They gonna kill you. They gonna kill you and whoever else coming with you. So we gotta think. You know what I'm saying? That's where they fall short at. They don't be thinking. Like, they need the human calculator on their side. He's like, man, they need somebody to help think, bro. Like, they just over there being aggressive. They gonna go shoot them up, bang, bang. It ain't gonna work like that, man. Not when this game is playing at a high level. You playing high risk, high reward. You know, you playing with your life. And you just gonna walk into a trap. You messing with these girls at the strip club. You know, they just bought their money anyway. They just some bounty hunter. So you can't really just trust them.
They don't care. As long as you got the money, we going to get them. We going to try anyway.
Like Franklin said, man, y'all some free agents. Like, look, y'all might as well come get with us. You have four, like Franklin, we offer full-time employment. You know what I'm saying? You get with us, and Jerome hit him with that leg. Look, you're going to get this one chance. Jerome already let him know you're going to get this one chance. Like, they're like, what if we come with y'all? Then Jerome kind of like, now he already know the game. You know what I'm saying? Jerome know the game. And Jerome shout out, like, you get one chance. Like, you don't rock with us, you already know what time it is.
Hey, that boy threw that water on that hood and like, gave him that ultimatum. It was like, shit,
We all in. We ain't got no damn choice.
You know what I mean?
Like, we all in. Because, like I said, man, look, you free agents. We got the money. We got more money than you can ever think of. We can pay you. You can be on call. You're going to get this money. You ain't got to be out here in the street eating what you kill every single time.
Yeah, or you can die right now.
You can die right now. Like, what you going to do?
What you going to do? Wanda was like, damn, Lee, you ain't telling about no gun and shit. You don't pay these bitches.
You in right now. You don't even realize you in right now.
Yeah, you in.
You working for us right now.
She like, oh, yeah. Oh, shit. Yeah. I'm like, man, Wanda still got that shit.
Wonder about this shit, bro. Hey, Reed, I thought Reed had kind of gave up on the whole lifestyle, man. I thought he had gave up. Then he went to the Harvey. Harvey gave him that pep talk. He like, man, he forgot who he was for a minute, bro. He literally forgot who he was for a minute, bro. He went sat down and talked with Harvey.
He cried in the car when he left Gustavo. Remember, he shouldn't be Gustavo in. He cried in the car. And I was looking at him. I was like, man, that nigga gonna cry in the car. Look, this nigga about to cry. I was like, already. What he called him? Not essay. He said
something in Spanish to him or something.
He's always compadre or amigo.
Yeah. He told me, like, he shook his hands, pulled him up close. Hey, watch your six. You know what I'm saying? I always have an exit plan. And don't trust him. He already let him know. I wouldn't trust me.
I always loved you, Gustavo. You was always my favorite. Because I was like, man, get your ass up out of here. I ain't none of these other cats. I ain't Franklin, Leon. You the CIA. I ain't soft on you. Man, get up. He was like, always, amigo. Kick rocks. Man, nah.
Hey, But yeah, hey, he went had that talk with Harvey. Harvey gave him a little pep talk, try to hire him. He like, look, I forgot who I was. Let me go do what I do. Let me go holler this reporter. And then I thought he was like, man, he gonna fold like this to the reporter too. He gonna fold like this.
When he went and got the drink, I said,
it's going down.
I said, there go Reed. I said, there you go, right there. When he went, he said, oh, you want something to drink? Ah, here you go.
Yeah, and she was so in awe of the moment. She was in awe, like, why he gonna tell me the whole story? And in a way, I think that was good for him too, because he was able to go and get that off his chest. You know what I'm saying? He probably had his whole weight of everything going on. He finally gonna be like, hey, look, I know I'm gonna kill her later. Let me go ahead and play it to her soft side and play it to her weakness. And then give her the story, make her feel good. And by the time that all I get through talking to her, this all this stuff I put in her drink gonna kick in. He timed it perfectly, bro. He timed it perfectly.
I'm telling you, That's Reed, bro. This is like, CIA. He know what shit is by walking. Two clicks that way. This nigga's a walking. Hey, this nigga's crazy. This is two clicks and then go. Bro, this nigga Reed is
he knew it, bro. He like, I'm gonna give him, you know, put the drink, I'm gonna drop this in her drink, I'm gonna give her 30 minutes, I'm gonna give her this story, I'm gonna walk out, I'm gonna drive off. She gonna think she all Gucci, and that thing, you know, her head gonna be on the steering wheel, and it's gonna be night night.
It's over, bro.
Choke it. Put them gloves on, smother, walk on by the bed, throw the pills in the bag. Now she OD drunk drive. Boom. Case closed.
Just like you said, bro. That man went ahead and talk about Ivy scooted over there with them silk pajamas he had on. Like he didn't play. Look, hey, you want to come work for me? Hey, he was like, bro. Let me get back to you on that. Hold on, bro.
Exactly. He like, I forgot who I was, man. I had to go get, because she had to know something's going to happen to her, bro. She going to go talk on the report. She going to go talk on this radio station, bro, and you hear Alton like, "You sure you want to do this?" Like, "Yeah, I want to do it."
You gonna do it by yourself. That told you the next time you ain't waking up. Told you this.
Told him, bro.
Like, come on, bro. How stupid?
She out here thinking it's a game, bro. It man, like, you can't be playing with our lives. This my life. You know what I'm saying? This my life.
Nigga, talking about you gonna tell my name? Okay.
Man. Alton gonna be the next, bro. He got to go. I don't think Franklin can do it because that's his pops. But I think, you know what I'm saying, if it happened, he won't be like just totally mad. You know what I'm saying? Because you know when Reed can't talk to him, I don't think Franklin got the guts enough to kill his pops. But if it like happened on the end where Reed kind of do it to him, you know what I'm saying? I think it'd be like, all right, it happened. You know what I mean? Like I didn't call the shot to kill my pops. But bro, you can't be out here snitching like that, bro. And put on the radio, bro. You know what I'm saying? You saw how he got his damn coat at the end when he saw old girl got down from in the car. When Irene died, he heard about on the news. He's like, oh shit, I gotta go. You know what I'm saying? He know what time then all of a sudden Reed pop up.
If she popped up to the hospital,
like, what about your pops? What are we gonna do about
it? Bro, you heard about it. You just heard about it the next morning, and you just get the next morning, it's too late.
Too late, bro.
Reed came over there and said straight up in the hospital, mom 10 yards away. What we gonna do about your pops?
We're gonna do about your pops, man.
He basically went to Franklin and told him, "Hey, I did my half. You said you could set your dad up. I told you I got the reporter. The reporter has got.
What you gonna do?
Now it's time for you to come on. His mama Sissy ain't gonna let that happen. Sissy, like, you know, that was a pivotal. I mean, not a pivotal, but an important. Important point too, part. If you see when they got the news about the reporter, right after Reed walk in, and then what, the mom looking at Reed like talking to.
That might have been her first time meeting. That probably been her first time seeing Reed because nobody has seen it.
No, but I'm thinking she's probably like, wait a minute, if he did that to her, and Alton told her.
He coming.
What is that conversation going? What is that conversation with? What is he talking to Franklin about now?
Going down. Dad.
Yeah, and man, hey, you know, hey, Sissy, his mom in love with Alton. Kirby. What's that? Kirby. Love with old Kirby.
He know what time it is, bro. It ain't no game now, bro. It's too late, bro. Like I said, man, that toothpaste out the tube, bro. Like you can't just go snitch, put it in the paper, and then. talk about, you know, you're going to fly off to Cuba and then don't go nowhere. And then you go put the reporter later on the radio. You know what I mean? Like, you're going to continue to try to flush this story out. Like, he think he going to be protected because he got it out in the open. But now, bro, it ain't going down like that, bro. They're going to catch you in them back alleys. You're going to die, bro. You can't be out here playing around. Die.
He probably would let it slide had they just killed her.
She wanted to did the radio because that's what killed him when she did the radio interview. That's what killed Reed. You know what I'm saying? They were like, we gotta get Reed up out of here. Like the first time the article, they're like, all right, okay, we might can make this work, we can shut it down. But then she go jump on the radio, like, all right, she gotta get out of here now. She out of here.
You gotta get out of here. And your pops won't let it go.
Yeah, bro, you out of here, bro.
Because you know what, Franklin might not know his pops did that.
About the radio thing, because he's been moving around all day. Yeah, because he's been moving around all day. He's been out there in the streets handling business.
So he probably don't even know his pops did it. Like, damn, you did it twice? You didn't just tell the reporter, then you brought it back?
Yeah, bro.
Then I see you up in the hospital hugging on my mama. Like, nigga, that ain't your job no more.
He told me, hey, he came quick, nigga. What you doing? That ain't your job no more.
What you doing?
You see Jerome, like, nigga, what you doing, nigga? We can get a squab right here. We can handle him right here.
Anyway, bro.
Yeah, bro. So, man, I like aggressive Jerome, bro. I like him, bro. I like aggressive. Angry Jerome, man. Jamming Jerome. I like angry Jamming Jerome. You know what I'm saying? He get that pistol in his hand. He go out there and get about that action, bro. He shot Khadijah in the throat. You know what I'm saying? Leon was trying to be all soft, like, hey, I'm sorry. She like, nigga, what? You think I'm, why I got to be the bigger person? Why?
I'm going to hunt you. Watch the bleed out. Like, nigga.
Hit in the throat, bro. Like, he could have easily hit in the head. He hit in the throat, let it bleed out on the floor, bro. Like, and just watch the bleed out. And then here come Leon on the knees, like, man, what are you doing? I'm trying to apologize. Yeah. Like, man, I'm trying to apologize.
I'm trying to give her an option. Like, nigga, you trying to give her an option? She trying to kill you, bro.
No, she tried. She shot my wife. She shot Louis. That's what he. I think that was the personal side of it. Where she shot Louis. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So he like, she gotta go. You know what I'm saying? I told Louis she gotta go. And then you saw how the two hitters. You saw them two hitters back there. Like, this nigga crazy. You know, Jerome crazy.
That nigga crazy.
Don't cross him, bro. Don't cross him. Franklin's just like standing there. Like, look, come on, Leon. We gotta go, man. We gotta go.
Yeah. Get your ass up, little Leon. You got to put Leon back in the house now. Like, this nigga, Leon, you know what's about to happen? One of two things going to happen to Leon. Leon going to either get killed or Leon going to get on that rock.
Man, I can see he going to be, hey, bro.
He going to be on that rock.
But you can even see
it in his eyes. Remember how Pookie was? He was like, I can't. They trying to struggle. That nigga, he gonna be, hey, Leon stress, bro. That stress, he gonna be like, I gotta hit it one time. Nigga, he gonna turn to Wanda.
You see it in his eyes when he was sitting on the picnic table in the project when Jerome walked up. He ain't want that smoke, bro. He ain't want to get back out there in them street, dog. He don't want him, bro.
Big Dion was about to, hey.
Hey, he give him that issue, bro. He acting like D'Angelo from the Y. He acting all soft now, bro. Like, come on, Leon.
Man, like, come on, Leon. Hey, Jerome ain't missed a step. Boy, he walked up with your bitch about 450, huh, nigga? My nigga? Hey, I don't give a damn. Hey.
Hey, Mr. Limpy.
Hey, Mr. Hey. Like, I tell you, if a nigga walk outside with the nipple shorts, you don't want to see that man. Hey, he got some hair.
Bro, he out there with a jacket with no shirt on, bro, in the middle of summer, bro. He's seared. Man. He's seared. He about that action. He better do something.
Hey, he don't want to mess with that grown ass. Jerome got that nigga look like he the gorilla nigga right there with Jerome. Jerome like, nigga, you better sit your ass down somewhere. You come eat these motherfucking hot dogs that got up in the grill.
Hey, we want to take a quick